name is Namita Kaur. Today I'm going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 2, and the name of chapter inside our earth. First thing you have to understand, what is earth? The earth comprises 3 layers, earth, mantle, and core. Our earth is made by 3 layers, earth, mantle, and core. By this layer, our earth is made up. What is changes take in inside as well as outside the earth? Earth is made of details, but changes in earth in every time in our earth. The constant changes is happened in our earth every time. Firstly, you all are when the earth is separate from the solar, from the sun, it was a hot planet. But when the time is passes, thousands of years after, the earth is cooled down and we have hence the light is possible in the earth. But still some changes is occur in the earth. What is interior of the earth? We are discussing about the interior of the earth. So firstly we have to understand what is the interior of the earth. The earth is made up of 3 concentric layers, crust, mantle and core. In interior we talking about the interior part, internal part of the earth. It is made of 3 layers. The uppermost layer covers the earth surface is called the crust. The uppermost layer of the earth is called the crust. It is about 35 kilometers thick and the crust is 35 kilometers thick on the continental masses and only 5 kilometers thick on the ocean floor. We are talking about continental masses is the land. The land is usually that is for the continent. The continent in continent area, the earth, the thickness of the earth first layer is 35 kilometers, but in ocean area, there is also the ocean floor is there, earth is soil is there, earth is there. So the thickness of this layer, uppermost layer, the crust thickness is 5 kilometers thickness. In the ocean area, it is 5 kilometers, and in the normal land area, there is 35 kilometers thickness of the earth. It is made up of silica and aluminium, which that's why it's called the CR. We call the CR because it is made of the silica and aluminium. The earth surface is made of two things, that is silica and aluminium, that's why we call them CR. Now we are coming to oceanic crust. What is the oceanic crust? Mainly consists of the silica and aluminium. CR is the land continental crust is made of silica and aluminium, and oceanic crust is made of the silica and magnesium. So we call the oceanic crust as the CIMA. Just below the crust is the mantle. After the crust, there is another layer. We call that layer mantle. Up to extent of 2,900 meters, and the extent of the mantle is 2,900 meters. And talking about the innermost layer, upper layer is the core. The innermost layer is called core with a radius of 3,500 kilometers. The radius of the core is 3,000. Our earth is shaped by the shape. And there is because the circle shape is also so the circle has a radius. That's why we call the radius is used in this term because this is the shape of the earth. See the radius of the innermost layer is 3,500 kilometers, and it is made of the nickel and iron. And the third layer is made of the nickel and iron, and it is called the nickel. We call the nickel because of nickel and the iron layer. The central core has a very high temperature and pressure. And in this value, we are talking about the core. In the central part of the core, the temperature was very high and pressure was very high in the central part of the core. Rock and mineral. The earth crust is made of various types of rock. The earth crust is made of various types of rock and natural masses of the mineral. Matter that makes up the earth crust is called rock. The matter that makes all the minerals and matter that makes the earth crust is called the rock. There are 3 major types of rock. We are discussing about the rock. The rocks are 3 types: igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. There are 3 types. rock is formed. And these rocks we call the glacial rocks. Yeah, primary rocks. They are of two types. Extrusive and glacial rocks are intrusive glacial rocks. The rock is glacial rock is also divided into two types. Rocks roll down and break into a small fragment, and these small particles are called the sediments. When the rock is broken down and made of small, small particles, these small particles are called the sediments. These sediments are transported from from the layer of the rock, and these types of rock are called the sedimentary rocks. The sediments that collect by the compression of the environment, that can create the sedimentary rock. Ignition and sedimentary rock can change into metafire rock, where the both rocks are meet and they or prepare the metafire rock. Under the great heat and pressure, how the metafire rock occurs? When the ignition rock and sedimentary rock come together and they work and the great heat and the pressure. After the great heat and pressure, the ignition and sedimentary rock become the metafire rock. The process of the transportation of the rock from one to another is called the rock cycling. And the transportation from the one rock to another rock is called the rock cycling. Rocks are made of different minerals. These rocks are made of the minerals. Minerals are naturally occurring substances which have certain physical properties and definite chemical composition. The minerals we come from the earth, they have different properties and their chemical composition are different. Every minerals have different composition and different properties. Now we are discussing some key elements of this structure. The uppermost layer over the earth surface. The uppermost layer is the layer that we are dealing with the uppermost layer, and that is very thin. And we call this layer surface. We are talking about the CR, the continental mantle of the earth. We talk about continental mantle means the land layer of the earth surface. Made of consisting of silica and aluminium. That's why we call it CR. Alloy from silica and alloy from aluminium, and it creates the CR. Okay, we talk coming about the CR. The oxygen crust means the crust that is found in the ocean area. It means consisting of silica and magnesium. It is made up by the silica and magnesium, and it is therefore called the CR because they are. As I call silica, stand for the magnesium. So this both silica and magnesium make the ocean crust of the earth. Now we are coming to next point, that is the second layer, that is mantle. This layer is the within the earth. It is just after the earth crust. It extended up to the depth of 2,900 km, and depth of the mantle is 2,900 km. Below the crust, and it starts from the crust. Now we are going to rock. What is rock? A rock is a natural mass of the minerals matter that makes up the earth crust. This rock is made by the earth crust. And the minerals are rooted in this rock. The rocks are made by the minerals and substances. Now we are coming to the next point, that is ignition rocks. These rocks are formed by the cooling and solidifying molten magma, by the magma or molten magma was cooled down, that is, it was solidified, and the solidification of this. The magma becomes the ignition rock. Now, what is lava? It is fiery bright water and much of the fiery color of fire and red color is here, and melted magma coming out from the interior of the earth on its surface, and it comes from the interior part, the interior of the earth called the lava. It is the color of the lava is fiery red color, and it is magma and comes from the earth interior part. That's the ignition rock. when the molten lava comes from the earth surface, molten lava comes from the superior earth, it gradually cools, it cools down and becomes solid, and this becomes solid and rock forms in this way on the earth after the distribution process. And after that, the rock is formed. So this is the rock molten distribution process. Crystallization of when the molten magma cool down deeply, that means inside the earth magma is cool down. The earth was solid into this emission rock around that time. Each rock was formed, that is what it is. Magma come out and it go cool down and it drop. But in this, it is deep enough to move deep down in the earth and cool down and make the emission rock. Now coming to sediment. What is sediment? These are the small fragments of the rock, the small particle of the rock that is collected in one area is called the sediment. Sedimentary rock, when the rock is sediment, the rock sediment is the rock particle of the rock somewhere hardened. Means we are compressed and become hard. Layer of the rock are found. These type of rock known as the sedimentary rock. The sediment of the rock loose down and so with the evaporation and some water and it is by the compression and it becomes harder, is called the sedimentary rock. Now we are coming to the rock sediment. The process of the transformation of the rock from one to another is known as the rock cycle. When the one rock is transformed and becomes the another rock, like each rock transforms and becomes the metabolic rock, is called the rock cycle. Now we are going to minerals. What is minerals? Minerals are naturally occurring substances. It is a natural substance which has certain physical and minerals have certain physical properties as well as the chemical composition of the both of them. So this is the key point of this chapter, and by these three points and by the video you can understand whole chapter. In this chapter we learn the layer, interior layer of the earth and the rock cycle. So these are the interior part of the earth. Thank you, and we'll have a nice day.